It can be a cruel game sometimes, Herc. Yes. Yeah, and they dug themselves a hole in the first leg, didn't they? And they came this close to climbing out of that hole.
Yeah. But how many times have we said, oh, this close, you know, we're getting there, MLS is getting there, these moral victories mean nothing. Now, when this game, the first leg, when it was about to start, I went on air and I said that if Toronto FC loses this final to this Chivas team, it is a failure of epic proportions because they just come off a treble-winning season. Mm. They just eliminated one of the best teams in this continent and also maybe South America, one of the richest rosters in Club Tigres in the quarterfinals. They go on to eliminate in two games one of the most historic teams in Mexico in Club America. And the way they did it, to then go on and face this Chivas, who sits 17th place in league play, no chance of playoffs, their second consecutive tournament without a playoff, with all the problems surrounding Chivas, out of the four Mexican clubs, they are the weakest team in this competition, and they make it. You would have put everything on the house with Toronto, and they lose. And then we see the second leg, and the way they started out, four center backs injured, not available. You don't have Mavinga. You don't have Drew Moore. Yep. You don't have Hagelin. You don't have Zabaleta. Yep. And you have to play Michael Bradley and Gregory Vanderbilt in a center back tandem. On the left, Ashton Morgan. On the right, Auro. You're playing pretty much Bradley in a Mascherano-type role with outside backs. And the way they played and the way they dictated pace and tempo against a very good transition Chivas team changed my reflection on this being a failure. But still, there are no moral victories. They got as close as penalty kicks, but Toronto will be kicking themselves for what they missed and did not do in the first leg.
The first leg, I always go back to that, Paul. That's where they dug themselves a hole. That was the only game in this entire run they put together where they kind of just eased up a little bit. The first game, they were favourites in.
In Toronto, we all listened to what everybody's been saying about this Chivas side, and we thought, well, Toronto can really absolutely hammer this side at home and put the tie to bed. But as Herc says, injuries, missed chances, missed opportunities. You could see the players, how disappointed they were. They knew that it was in their grasp.
Mm. Look, the thing for me is, yes, OK, Toronto dig themselves a hole in the first leg, but you climb out of that hole during the course of the second leg. And now it's an opportunity for you to take this tie by the scruff of the neck. Chivas, under pressure at home, you're behind. You know what the fans are, you know that the fans are starting to turn. And yet still, despite the talent, despite the experience you have at your disposal, you allow a desperately poor Chivas. And of the three teams, of the three U.S. teams, MLS teams you see that get to the CONCACAF final, this is without question the weakest of the Mexican opponents. And Herc continues to tell me that this is the best MLS outfit we've seen in Toronto. And if so, you've got to make better use of the advantages when you do get them. Mm.
And that's where they are at the moment. You see 17th place, Chivas. They were there for the taking. When there is a high-profile failure like this, the star players get put under the microscope even more. And Jozy Altidore and Michael Bradley are two players who've been accused before, Herc, of not stepping up in the biggest games. This is Michael Bradley's penalty in the 2016 final, which Toronto lost to Seattle. Of course, they beat them the following year.
I'm of the mindset anybody can miss a penalty kick. But to miss a penalty kick, you have to have the stones to go up and take one.
Right.
Michael Bradley is that type of leader. If you would have told me he would have stepped into center back position and had that type of performance like he did, I would have not believed you. In a venue where Toronto has never won. Toronto, six attempts in Mexico, have never won. To win the seventh time and then tell me Sebastian Giovinco is going to get on the scoreboard and Jozy Altidore is going to get on the scoreboard, I would have told you that is theirs. But because of the transition and because of Rodolfo Pizarro and how fast and dynamic this Chivas team is, I couldn't have guaranteed you they would have kept the zero, and they did not.
Look, I don't put the penalty miss down to Michael Bradley. These things happen. You can't fault the player for stepping up and taking the kick. But he's missed penalties in big occasions. Mm. And sometimes leadership is about saying, I'm not the one for this kick. I'm not the one to take it fifth. Or more to the point, for Greg Vanney to say, Michael, as good as you've been, Don't have you in my first five.
And Shaq, really quick to counterpoint that, and I agree with you, maybe that should be the case, but if you look on the bench at that moment, who else does Greg Vanney have? He's exhausted all his options.
Yeah. Josie and Michael get the attention, but Marky Delgado scores, Paul. Mm-hmm. We're having a completely different conversation. He should have scored.
Yeah, exactly. So, look, I try to cut him a little bit of slack because it's a high-pressure game. It's not the easiest technique in the world. But at this level, with what's at stake, he has got to at least hit the frame.
He's got all that's standing between MLS and doing this.
It always is.
Tiny bit of composure.
Always about small margins.
Tiny bit of composure.
It's tricky because it should be a tiny bit of control, and I'm with you. He hits the frame, that's something else. Keeper makes a save, that's something else. Right. Defender gets in there, that's something else, but you have to hit the frame. But Marky Delgado, one of the better players for Toronto. That's not the reason Toronto did not win this series. I could look back to the first leg where there are 3-4 clear-cut chances at home, and you don't take advantage of them. That's just the most blaring case because that's the last image we'll have of Toronto in this competition.
Just as a final aside before we leave this, what did you make of going straight to penalties? Do you like that? No extra time, going
like
straight
it.
From the 90 minutes to penalties. Herc, you've been involved in both scenarios, I think.
Correct, yes. I would have loved to see this extended. I think it goes to prove who the better team, because once it's in penalty kicks, I don't think...
So you want the extra 30 minutes.
Yes.
You want the extra time.
I don't mind the extra 30 minutes, but sometimes I'm questioning, and I have to admit I'm a little bit undecided on this, if away goals then does count in the extra 30 minutes, because at that point it's all even.
Yeah.
That's my only question mark here, and I'm a little bit undecided.